Esquivel is of course most famous in this country for her novel Like Water for Chocolate. I'm not going to try and say it in Spanish for fear of creating a diplomatic incident. Like Water for Chocolate, the novel, and the globally successful movie that followed. The novel sold several million copies worldwide, and the movie, she wrote the screenplay, won, I believe, all 11 of that year's Ariel's, Mexico's version of the Oscars. Its blend of love, sex, magic realism, brilliant prose, and incredible food proved a formula that many since have emulated and none have equaled, and made me, I can tell you, extremely nervous about which restaurant to book we're having afterwards. Laura has become a key figure in the Latin American canon, and especially to the post-boom generation, who she helped bring the female voice to prominence in what was a very male-dominated Latin American boom of writers. But of course there's a whole deal more to Miss Esquivel's career than simply one book. She began her writing career while teaching at primary school, I believe, writing theatre plays, firstly for her children, and then for the Mexican theatre more widely, and later for television. And it may be the extraordinarily visual quality of her work was honed writing for performance in this way. All her novels cross traditional genre categories as well as time, and are infused with discussions on the nature of love, the erotic, and the visceral qualities of sensorial emotion. This is graphically shown by her second novel, Law of Love, set in the 23rd century, and a multimedia text that includes illustrations as well as a CD of music. She was telling me earlier today that she herself organized the production of. Her third novel, Swift as Desire, is a contemporary family drama. And Malinche, from 2006, reimagines the native translator and mistress of the conquistador, Hernan Cortes, in a more sympathetic light, and includes some beautiful illustrations by Laura's translator tonight, Mr. Jordi Castells. Perhaps you'd like to stand up for him. Here he is. She's written highly regarded cookbooks, heady blends of philosophy and food, books of essays, and has just finished another book, a politically and socially motivated manual on personal independence in an age of consumerism and alienation, which reflects her other persona as a significant actor in Mexico's political environment. So we're very honoured indeed to have her here to speak, along with Jordi, who will provide a simultaneous translation to Laura's lecture, which will be delivered in Spanish. And she will take questions thereafter from the audience in her excellent English. So what I'd like you to do now, if you wouldn't mind, is just pass all those single words along each way to the end. And my charming assistants, who I believe are at the back, will gather them in. Enough of me, and please give a huge Leicester welcome to Laura Esquivel.
Simultaneous translation, but as they're very, there are a few native Spanish speakers, we, Laura decided it would be very annoying to them, so we're going to do phrase by phrase translation.
Yeah, for me it's really a great pleasure to be here, and I'm so sorry that I'm going to read in Spanish, because sometimes my English is not good enough. So that's why Jordi is going to help me, and I want to thank the School of English, University of Leicester, Santander, and in very, very special way to Harry Whitehead, because he's the one who contacted me and with the help of everybody, it make possible my first visit here. That couldn't be more, ¿cómo se dice este? De novela, con toda esta niebla maravillosa. Es la primera vez que estoy en Inglaterra, bueno, físicamente, porque la comencé a recorrer hace muchos años a través de las lecturas de sus grandes escritores.
This is the first time I'm in the UK, well, physically, because I started knowing it many years ago, guided by the tales of the great English writers.
A través de sus letras, yo supe de los horrores de sus calles, de las magnificencias de sus bosques, de la belleza de su arquitectura, del humor de sus habitantes, de sus amores, de sus pasiones y de la niebla.
Through the words, I knew of the smell of the streets, the magnificence of the forests, the beauty of the architecture, the sense of humor of its inhabitants, their love, their passions, and most of all, the fog.
Creo que la primera historia que me cautivó a muy, muy temprana edad fue la de Robin Hood, pero luego pasé por muchos autores que me marcaron profundamente, pero nadie como Shakespeare.
I think the first story that captivated me at a very early age was Robin Hood, but then I went through many other authors that really marked me, but nobody such as Shakespeare.
Antes de ser escritora, fui maestra que escribía obras de teatro y programas de televisión para niños.
Before being a writer, I was a teacher and I wrote plays and TV shows for children.
El teatro, pues, fue mi puerta de entrada a la escritura.
Theater was my entry towards writing.
La estructura dramática es una herramienta indispensable en mi obra.
Dramatic structure is a very important tool in my work.
Es tan importante que la utilizo para todo, incluso cuando escribo novelas.
It's very important, so important that I use it for everything, even when I'm writing novels.
Me recurro a ella, pues su manejo adecuado me permite organizar, analizar, modificar. En otras palabras, me permite crear con mucha mayor libertad.
I use dramatic structure because its adequate management allows me to organize, analyze, modify, or in few words, to create with a much greater freedom.
En últimas fechas he recurrido a ella para diseñar un manual de dramaturgia personal que se publicará el mes entrante y que lleva como título Escribiendo la nueva historia o cómo dejar de ser víctima en 12 sesiones.
These last days I have used it to design a personal drama structure manual which will be published next month and is titled Writing Our New Story or How to Stop Being a Victim in 12 Sessions.
Lo cual es una total mentira porque lleva mucho más que eso dejar de ser víctima.
This is a complete lie because it will take a lot longer than 12 sessions to stop being a victim.
Pero bueno, era el gancho para traer.
That was a hook.
Para que intente.
So people can try to stop being a victim.
Este manual es resultado de un taller que yo estuve impartiendo en México con buenos resultados.
This manual is the result of a workshop, a writing workshop that I have been teaching in Mexico with very good results.
Y es refleja mi pasión por la estructura dramática y su utilidad en la vida diaria.
It reflects my passion for dramatic structure and its usefulness in everyday life.
Porque nos puede servir la estructura simple dramática de yo voy a empezar aquí y yo quiero terminar aquí, es esta estructura y qué pasos debo seguir para ir de aquí a acá, nos permite en verdad transformar nuestra vida, transformar aquellos elementos que están obstaculizando nuestro camino.
This simple dramatic structure of getting from point A to point B can really help us to overcome the obstacles that are in our lives.
La creación dramática es lo que en lo personal me ha permitido conocerme, analizarme, corregir el rumbo.
Dramatic structure is what has allowed me personally to know myself, to analyze myself, and to correct my path.
También me ha permitido imaginarme en acción.
It has also allowed me to imagine myself in action.
Convertirme en un ente actuante que participa dentro de la sociedad.
To become an active being that participates actively within society.
Que cambia, que se transforma, que se reinventa, que se recrea minuto a minuto.
That changes, that is transformed, that is reinvented, and that is recreated minute by minute.
Y así puedo pasar de ser cocinera a ser escritora.
So I can go from being a cook to being a writer.
O bailadora de danzones. Pero lo que me permite es conectarme con una fuerza creativa.
What it allows me is to connect with a creative force.
¿Y de dónde surge la creación?
And where does creation come from?
Se podría decir que la escritura es producto de un Big Bang imaginativo.
Could we say that writing is a product of an imaginative Big Bang?
Todo comienza, toda vida comienza con un corazón, con un pulso, con una vibración.
All life begins with a heart, with a beat, with a vibration.
Nuestros antepasados decían que todo tiene un corazón.
Our ancestors would say that everything has a heart.
Desde el más pequeño átomo hasta la estrella más lejana, toda vida en nuestro universo posee un corazón que pulsa.
From the smallest atom to the farthest star, all life in our universe has a heart that beats.
La tierra pulsa, el cielo pulsa, vibra, danza.
Earth beats, sky beats, vibrates and dances.
Cuando una palabra y un pensamiento se unen en un solo pulso, en una sola vibración, la materia toma forma y surge un nuevo corazón.
When one word and one thought are joined together in one vibration, matter takes shape and a new heart emerges.
Y cuando deja de latir, la vida se detiene.
And when it stops beating, life stops.
En los últimos tiempos la Tierra ha acelerado su pulso. Nosotros también. Sin embargo, lo hacemos por separado, a contrarritmo.
These last few years, Earth has accelerated its pulse. So have we, but we do it separately, at a counter rhythm.
Vivimos en desarmonía con la naturaleza y con nuestros semejantes.
We live in disharmony with nature and with our peers.
Tenemos que corregir el rumbo y recorrer nuevos senderos si es que queremos sobrevivir como especie.
We have to correct our path and to walk new ones if we want to survive as a species.
Y estoy segura que el corazón es el que va a marcar el paso. Que el corazón es lo que va a unir palabra y pensamiento para repetir el misterioso acto de la creación de un nuevo mundo.
I'm sure that the heart is what will set the beat. And that the heart is what will join word and thought to repeat the mysterious act of creation of a new universe.
Y en ese rediseñar es donde los seres humanos jugamos un papel importante dentro de la sociedad, ya que funcionamos de igual manera que las células lo hacen dentro del cuerpo humano.
It's in this redesign where human beings play an important part within society, because
así como como ellas forman parte de un tejido, de un órgano o de un sistema complejo, nosotros nos agrupamos socialmente y diseñamos fórmulas de convivencia.
Just like cells form part of tissue, organs, or complex systems, we come together socially and design formulas of cohabitation.
Compartimos y reproducimos patrones de pensamiento que mantenemos vigentes en la medida en que consideramos que no son de utilidad.
We share and reproduce patterns of thought that we maintain in function as long as we consider that they are useful to us.
Vivimos en un mundo interconectado donde compartimos mucho más pensamientos de los que imaginamos, ya que nuestras mentes están totalmente entrelazadas y tienen el poder de transmitir y recibir información.
We live in an interconnected world where we share a lot more thoughts than we imagine because our minds are completely intertwined and they have the power to transmit and receive information.
Los nuevos científicos, como el inglés Rupert Sheldrake, nos hablan de la forma en que este intercambio constante de datos va generando lo que se podría considerar como genes de información colectiva.
The new scientists like Rupert Sheldrake tell us about the way that this constant exchange of data generates what could be considered collective information genes.
Ya que la genética no es otra cosa que información que permanece.
Because genetics is nothing other than information that remains.
A nivel celular, nuestra herencia genética organiza la materia, determina el color de nuestros ojos, la predisposición a tal o cual enfermedad y en general al funcionamiento de nuestro organismo.
At a cellular level, our genetic inheritance organizes matter, determines the color of our skin, our eyes, or the predisposition to any other disease, and generally the functioning of our organism.
Se distribuyen funciones, se crean sistemas. Se puede decir que la vida es un sistema ordenado que perdura en la medida en que actúa coordinadamente contra el caos.
Functions are distributed, systems are created. We could say that life is an ordered system that remains as long as it acts in coordination against chaos.
Con el paso del tiempo, todo orden tiende al desorden debido a que la idea original que organizó la materia tiende a perder fuerza, a desdibujarse.
As time goes by, everything that's ordered tends towards disorder because the original idea that organized matter tends to lose strength or to fade.
Somos parte activa del cosmos. No hay que perderlo de vista.
We are an active part of the cosmos. We should not lose sight of this.
Toda la energía del universo está en constante movimiento, en constante transformación, lo cual siempre deja abierta la posibilidad de que surja un nuevo orden como resultado de un cambio entre las partes que lo conforman.
All the energy in the universe is in constant movement, in constant transformation, which always leaves the possibility that a new order may arise as a result of a change between the parts that form it.
El orden y el caos, jugando amigablemente, favorecen un campo enormemente creativo donde es posible que se genere una nueva forma de vida a partir de un sistema reordenado y reorganizado.
Order and chaos playing well together favor a hugely creative field where it's possible that a new way of life could be generated parting from a reordered and redesigned system.
La forma en que la materia se organiza mucho tiene que ver con la geometría y con las matemáticas.
The way in which matter is organized has a lot to do with geometry and math.
Así como se establecen distancias y coordenadas entre un punto y otro, así se van diseñando planos que representan proyectos de vida.
Just like we establish distances and coordinates between one point and another, so do we design blueprints that represent projects of life.
Cada uno de ellos tiene una línea en el tiempo, pero su camino se entrecruza con otras líneas.
Each one of them has a line within time, but its path is crossed with other lines.
Entre todos vamos formando bellas figuras geométricas, como si fuéramos un gigantesco caleidoscopio que cambia de color y de forma cuando una de sus piezas se mueve.
We all form beautiful geometric figures as if we were a giant kaleidoscope that changes color and form when one of its pieces moves in space.
Es con base a esos genes de información colectiva que regulamos nuestra conducta, nos organizamos dentro de la comunidad a la que pertenecemos, planeamos el funcionamiento de nuestras ciudades y elegimos a nuestros gobernantes.
It's based in these collective information genes that we regulate our conducts, that we organize within the community that we belong to, that we plan the functioning of our cities, and that we elect our governors.
Dentro de un momento vamos a ver cómo las palabras que ustedes nos proporcionaron van a integrar un caleidoscopio.
In a few moments we will see how the words that you wrote and you gave us will integrate a kaleidoscope of creation.
Y cada uno mandó una información.
Each one of you sent us a piece of information.
Independientemente de la que estamos compartiendo.
Independently from the information that we're sharing right now.
Y que es muchísimo.
It's a lot of information.
En este momento, el mundo ignora las necesidades de millones y millones de ciudadanos y le permite al 1% de la población actuar en contra del 99% restante.
At this point in time, the world ignores the needs of millions and millions of citizens and allows the 1% of the population to act against the remaining 99%.
¿Por qué? ¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué señales de, o qué información estamos transmitiendo entre nosotros que permiten esa descomposición social y la implantación de un sistema equivocado, un sistema económico equivocado?
Why? What's going on? What signs or information are we transmitting amongst each other that allow this social decomposition and the implementation of a wrong economical system?
En definitiva, hemos de estar haciendo algo que no está del todo correcto.
We're definitely doing something that's not right.
Estarán de acuerdo conmigo que tal vez es hora de recordar que todos estamos metidos hasta el cuello en el mismo problema y solo juntos podemos resolverlo.
You'll agree with me that maybe it's time to remember that we're all neck deep in the same problem and only together can we solve it.
Algunas situaciones tomarán más tiempo que otras en solucionarse, pero lo importante del caso es analizar la manera en que participamos de este caos.
Some situations might take longer than others to solve, but the important thing is to analyze the way in which we have participated in this chaos.
Creemos o nos hacen creer que de cara a la sociedad solo tenemos que responsabilizarnos por nuestras acciones. No así por nuestras emociones o pensamientos.
We believe, or we are made to believe, that in front of society, we only have to take responsibility for our actions, not so for our emotions or thoughts.
Sin embargo, tanto los unos como los otros nos afectan de igual manera el mundo que nos rodea.
Nonetheless, both thoughts and emotions affect the world around us.
Los pensamientos son energía en movimiento. Es infantil pensar que se quedan guardaditos aquí en la cabeza.
Thoughts are energy in movement. It's childish to think that they remain inside our heads.
Los pensamientos y las emociones salen de nosotros, se irradian y se contagian al exterior en forma invisible.
Thoughts and emotions become external. They irradiate and they affect the exterior in an invisible way.
Tal vez no se le toman cuenta porque no se ven. Pero definitivamente juegan un papel trascendente en el comportamiento de los seres humanos, pues todo está entrelazado.
They may not be taken into account because they are invisible, but they definitely play a transcendent part in the behavior of human beings because they are intertwined.
La gente entiende muy bien la interconexión, pero solo en el campo de la economía.
People understand interconnection very well, but only within the field of economics.
Saben que cuando una bolsa de valores cae, arrastra a las otras. Y por eso les entra pánico cuando la bolsa de Nueva York permanece a la baja. Pero les tiene muy sin cuidado si aumenta o disminuye la cantidad de deprimidos alrededor del mundo.
They know very well that when a stock exchange falls, it drags others down. That's why they panic when the New York Stock Exchange drops. But they don't care if people who are depressed are more or less in the world.
¿A qué inversionista le importa el dolor de la gente?
What investor cares about the pain of people?
¿A cuál banquero le preocupa la tristeza?
What banker cares about sadness?
Tal vez a Es la primera que
conoce.
Pierde el sueño ante la creciente ola de suicidios entre adolescentes a causa de la depresión.
What publicist loses sleep seeing a growing wave of suicides?
Todo aquello que no tiene vida material no les importa.
Everything that doesn't have material life is without meaning to them.
Los pensamientos son invisibles, sin embargo, como diría Galileo, se mueven.
Thoughts are invisible, but nonetheless, as Galileo would say, they move.
Viajan, se comparten, se transforman y se hacen presentes en la forma en que nos relacionamos con los demás.
They travel, they are shared, they are transformed, and they become present in the way that we relate to others.
En la manera en que trabajamos,
work,
en la manera en que consumimos, en la manera en que acumulamos, en la manera que compartimos, en la manera que celebramos, en la manera que amamos, en la manera en que escribimos.
In the way we consume, in the way we accumulate, in the way we share, in the way we celebrate, in the way we love, and in the way we write.
No deja de sorprenderme la cantidad de patrones de comportamiento que repetimos sin considerar que nos conducen a la destrucción.
I never cease to amaze by the amount of patterns of behavior that we repeat without considering that they lead us to destruction.
Si tomamos en cuenta que el orden y el desorden se retroalimentan el uno al otro y que la tensión que provocan estas dos fuerzas provoca un cambio enormemente creativo.
If we can realize that the counter between order and disorder who feed upon each other and the tension that these two forces provoke is conducive to a hugely creative field.
Podemos sacar provecho de los beneficios que nos brinda la ficción para sanar nuestras emociones, para escribir nuestras historias con toda libertad.
We can take advantage of the benefits that fiction gives us to heal our emotions and to write new stories in complete freedom.
Para escribir nuevas historias, tenemos que dejar de repetir las viejas historias.
In order to write new stories, we have to stop repeating old stories.
Y para eso tenemos que recuperar la libertad.
And for this, we have to regain our freedom.
Si nosotros como seres humanos solo fuéramos el efecto duradero del pasado, no tendría sentido intentar modificar el presente.
If we as human beings were only the lasting effect of the past, there would be no sense in trying to modify our present.
No habría posibilidad de hacerlo.
There would be no possibility to do so.
Pero qué tal si es posible vivir de otra manera?
But what if it's possible to live in a different manner?
¿Qué tal si? Es la pregunta que abre un mundo de posibilidades.
What if? That's the question that opens a world of possibilities.
El mundo que conocemos desaparece ante nuestros ojos y surgen nuevas situaciones, personajes, soluciones.
The world that we know disappears before our eyes and new situations, characters, and solutions arise.
Y cada nueva posibilidad provoca un efecto dominó en donde las viejas estructuras se derrumban ante las nuevas.
And every new possibility provokes a domino effect in which the old structures crumble before the new ones.
Haciendo un símil entre la estructura que sostiene un edificio y la que sostiene un ser humano, encontraríamos que en ambos casos hay eventos pasados que nos sacudieron, que nos dejaron grietas, que nos afectaron en los cimientos.
If we make a comparison between the structure that holds a building and the structure that holds a human being, we would find that in both cases there are past events that shook us, that cracked us, that affected our foundations.
Si el daño fue muy grave, corremos el riesgo de colapsarnos.
If the damage was very grave, we may collapse.
La elección más sana en esos casos sería la de demoler para luego reconstruir.
The healthiest choice in those cases would be to tear down in order to rebuild.
Sobre el terreno vacío se puede diseñar una nueva distribución de espacios, erigir columnas más fuertes, reforzar los cimientos.
On the empty grounds we can design a redistribution of space, build stronger columns, and strengthen the foundations.
Si lográramos concebirnos como una obra de arte que se va construyendo minuto a minuto, sin el menor reparo, derrumbaríamos los muros que limitan o que ocultan nuestra verdadera imagen y levantaríamos unos nuevos.
If we can think of ourselves as a work of art that is building itself minute by minute, we would have no problem in tearing down walls that limit or that hide our true image, and we would raise new walls.
Esta reorganización, este jugar con múltiples posibilidades, este intercambiar roles y situaciones, tiene mucho que ver con la dramaturgia.
This reorganization, this playing with multiple possibilities, this interchange of roles and situations, has a lot to do with the dramatic structure.
En el campo de la creación dramática, se utilizan personajes arquetípicos que interactúan entre sí dentro de una determinada situación y cuentan con la posibilidad de poder elegir entre una o más posibilidades.
In the field of dramatic creation, we use archetypal characters that interact between themselves within a determined situation and count with the possibility or the ability of choosing between one or more paths.
Elegir es renunciar.
To choose is to renounce or to give up.
Cuando uno se inclina por una opción, automáticamente desaparece la otra.
When you choose one option, the other one disappears automatically.
Pero desaparece del todo o queda latente en una especie de mundo paralelo.
But does it disappear as a whole or does it remain in a sort of parallel world?
Or twilight zone. Porque, por ejemplo, si uno de nuestros personajes cambia de dirección, la historia cambiará junto con él.
For example, if one of our characters changes direction, he'll make a story change along with him.
Pero si decidiera volver atrás y elegir nuevamente, podría hacerlo. Porque la posibilidad que en determinado momento rechazó sigue estando abierta.
But if he decided to turn back and to choose again, he could do so. Because the possibility that he had rejected at a determinate time is still open.
No muere.
It doesn't die.
Cualquier utopía que alguien haya imaginado alguna vez existe en el imaginario colectivo, aunque nadie la haya hecho realidad.
Any utopia that anybody has ever imagined still exists in the collective imaginary, even though nobody has ever realized it.
Si alguien pudiera ponerla en práctica, si la eligiera como opción de vida, la veríamos convertirse en realidad.
If somebody could really put it in practice, if they could choose it as a life choice, it would become a reality.
Somos nosotros los que vamos co-creando el mundo con nuestras elecciones.
It is we who are co-creating the world with our choices.
Bayard Rustin decía que la historia no es un accidente, es una elección.
In the Grustin said, history is not an accident, it is a choice.
Y en este momento, yo creo que nos surge en todo el mundo nuevas elecciones, nuevas opciones.
And at this time, I think it's very important for us all over the world to take new decisions, to make new choices.
Necesitamos nuevos creadores. Como todos los que están aquí.
We need new creators like all of you who are here.
Necesitamos que imaginen todas las utopías que puedan.
We need you to imagine all the utopias you can imagine.
Se vale lo que sea.
Anything goes.
Porque realmente creo que es el momento de un cambio.
Because I really feel it's the time for a change.
De un cambio colectivo.
For a collective change.
Y ahora quisiera que intentáramos hacer un poco de magia
to do a little bit of magic.
Con las palabras que ustedes nos mandaron.
What the words you sent us.
Que representan algo y van a formar algo. Necesito, yo creo que voy a necesitar primero un voluntario.
I think I'm going to need one volunteer first. One volunteer to come up.
No pasa nada. Sí. Okay. No falta. Please come here. Here are your possibilities, the field, enormous field of possibilities. So you will choose only 10 papers. It's your election. 10 papers. Don't read it.
Moonbeam.
Ah.
idea come to you if you analyze them? You have two laws, you have women or women, you have wonderful things. What image could represent this thing? Or scene. Please put me one scene, like in the movies, one scene with the, in which you can integrate these 10 papers.
Possibly an argument, a heated argument, because you have the freedom in the speech, you have ambiguity about what could happen next, you have love because heated passion, you have moonbeam, possibly hope, and Mexico.
Don't you mean
it could be in Mexico. There's chaos because it's chaotic. Revolution could be a change. Imagination because you're always having to think of new things to say to the person. And lemons. You could be fighting about lemons.
What would be the main fear of my protagonist?
Empezar por una emoción, eso me dispara todo.
I start with one emotion and then everything comes from that.
Una emoción te puede decir.
One emotion can tell you.
Esa persona qué haría.
What would that person
do? What
would
¿cómo reaccionaría?
How would they react?
¿Con quién? Entonces, cuando una persona en su vida
so
ha repetido.
In their life has repeated.
Historias dolorosas una y otra vez.
Painful stories, one and time again.
Es porque hay una emoción que no ha trabajado.
It's because there's an emotion there that they haven't worked on.
Y que no ha liberado.
And they haven't released.
Y que busca repetir.
And that seeks to
repeat. Es por eso que pensamiento y emoción están totalmente conectados.
Are completely interconnected.
Entonces ahí es donde
so,
es tan útil también la dramaturgia,
so
no solo para escribir
no
profesionalmente, para tener éxito
to
como escritor o no. Lo importante es que
there's
las palabras nos conecten con un mundo
words connect us to a world
de símbolos, con un mundo fuera del tiempo, fuera de las
time,
imágenes, fuera,
images,
pero que está dentro de nosotros.
But inside of us.
Me gustaría que si hay otro voluntario, hiciéramos otro ejercicio
to do another exercise
de elección.
Of choice.
Anímense. Sí, allá.
Yo.
love. Freedom. Action.
Yeah.
Porcupine. bullying. Inevitable. Blood. Cat. path. The quotidian.
So again, there is an image or a story that in which you can organize those works.
I sort of see kind of a sad scene because we have the word bullying as well, so it could perhaps be maybe a child or a teenager going up to their parents saying that I'm not really happy at school, there's no peace in my life at the moment, I'm being bullied, I just want to be free because we've got freedom, I just want to be free from the bullying. Can you help me take action? As we've got action, it's happening every day. Cotidian is the Spanish word for daily. You see? Yeah. It's inevitable that if it doesn't stop now, the porcupine will be. The porcupine, and also the cat as well. The cat will get me and draw my blood.
So maybe the porcupine is the bully. But the inevitable thing is that love prevails. Thank you so much.
A ver, ahora una maestra que enseña español, a ver si ella es que elige.
Somebody teaches Spanish.
Yeah.
Aquí está.
Ahí está. For instance, we attract in our life exactly like this, persons or situations. It's like if we write in the web, freedom. But if we are writing every day the same word, every day, it will come the answer. It will come. For instance, if a woman has been abandoned and she's thinking every day, oh, soy abandonable, ¿cómo se dice, Jordi?
I am abandonable?
Yeah. Va a llegar el hombre que la va a abandonar inevitablemente.
A man will come who will inevitably abandon.
El cambio, tenemos que reorganizar.
We have to reorganize and to send the correct information out there.
Para que venga la correcta respuesta.
The correct answer can be received.
Love.
Oh, I'm so happy. You meant my day. Love.
Story. Atmospheric. Rainbow. Rico, which is rich. Just to prove I can speak Spanish. Duck. Loca. Crazy. Aguantando.
Oh.
Aguantando, holding on.
Memories and train. So I'm going to say this is an atmospheric love story on the train station platform with an enduring crazy duck. Enjoying the rich view of a very beautiful rainbow. And the memories of the rainbow will last for a very long time.
Right, university. University, embryo. Dream, meticulous. Pool.
Turient? Parturient?
No, okay.
Parturienta, podría ser?
Yeah, yeah.
About to birth.
I have a cake. Brioche. Impaled. Transmit those feelings across to the people who are around you. I'm sure you feel as though you've been impaled, actually. But embryo, pool, birthing pools on a serious note all around you. I'd celebrate with cake and brioche. And I think, I suppose the fit with the university is probably where I'm struggling, but actually, you know, that's where you learn. That's where you learn about life and how you want to take it forward. So, all starts with there, really.
Oh, wow. So now it's well, let me just take one. Tomato. Thank you.